Praxis Prepper.
Hey everybody, this is Praxis, and what a week last week. I know I had a lot of video drops. It was a very busy week. I'm not going to do that all the time. Those two bird videos about the dead bird, I had intended to release those last week, but the other video that I had was the one about, like, you know, moving the location for the Alien Invasion series. That was sort of an accident. I'd forgotten to release that earlier, and that's why that was kind of out of sequence like that. But anyway, busy week, and super busy week for unsubscribing on my channel. By the way, if you can hear the splashing, my boy's over here, he's just playing in the water next to me. But yeah, it was a really big week for people unsubscribing from my channel. And I have those now and then, and usually they correspond with me talking about, you know, something relating to climate change. You know, people find that offensive, they don't want to hear about that. Maybe if I'm talking about something about the Trump administration and something that I think that they're doing that isn't working so great, there's certain people that just, you know, don't want to hear anything that could be potentially seen as being negative about Donald Trump. I've even done videos about Donald Trump where I say that he's going to be blamed for something, and people don't even listen to the whole video when they think that I'm, down on Donald Trump, even though the topic of the video was that I think he's going to get inappropriately blamed for something. So there's not a lot of thinking that goes on in a lot. A plane going overhead. There's not a lot of thinking that goes on, you know, before a lot of these people unsubscribe. So, you know, it's no loss. I'm happy to see them go. I like to have a roll of subscribers of people that are, you know, solid thinking people. You know, the types of people that are offended, the types of people that get afraid of different ideas, the types of people that don't like to be mentally challenged. Those aren't the kind of people that you would expect to survive in a crisis, because in a crisis, you know, an emergency situation, which is, you know, this channel's about, you know, emergency preparedness and everything. Those types of people aren't generally the kind of people that are going to have a lot of long-term survival, because they're not going to be able to evolve and change to different situations, because they have a rule book that is just set by, like, whatever, you know, their team, you know, whatever they think their team is, you know, whatever their team thinks is okay, that's what they believe, and anything else, you know, they're not interested in hearing that. But beyond that, those are the types of people that you don't necessarily even want to be surviving a crisis, because a lot of, you know, the closed-minded people, they tend to be argumentative, you know. I don't necessarily care if those people survive, you know. So, I mean, there's no tears shed over that. But it does get me thinking about, you know, why there are certain types of people that do that, and what are the implications for, you know, for their survival, for other people's survival. I know my channel tends to be, I have a very unpopular channel. For the amount of videos that I release, for the quality level that I release, I'm not saying, you know, patting myself on the back, oh, your videos are such great quality, but I mean, you know, I mean, they're edited, they have an opening, and, you know, they have reasonably good audio, that kind of stuff. It's not just, you know, someone's dashboard cam, you know, talking about whatever, you know, I put some effort into them. So for videos of this quality that, you know, are released as frequently as they are, I have a very, very unpopular channel. But amongst the people, you guys, that like my channel, it's a very popular channel, because there's not a lot of this out there. There are other channels that are great that, you know, have a lot of these same kind of ideas about being open to different ideas and everything. But, you know, there's not a lot of us out there. And for you guys, I know that you appreciate having a forum to talk about these things where people can be open-minded and listen to different points of view, because I think that's really important. It makes us all stronger. Being comfortable with the idea of uncertainty, being comfortable with the idea of finding out that you're wrong about something. I know for a lot of people, finding out that they were wrong about something, they see that as a negative. For me, at the end of the day, if I find out that I was wrong about something, that's a good day, because at the end of the day, I'm smarter than I was at the beginning of the day. So, I mean, being proven wrong, or, you know, even the suggestion that I may have to rethink something, that's an opportunity for growth, that's an opportunity for learning, and it's an opportunity for becoming a stronger, smarter person. That's the way I see it. That's not the way a lot of people see it. But I think a lot of the supporters of my channel, the hardcore supporters of my channel, and you guys know who you are, you guys love that. And you guys are comfortable living in that sort of world where, you know, it doesn't all have to be black and white. I think with the bird video, the big thing that, you know, probably people is, well, I was probably bothering people on both ends. A, I'm someone who's usually a vegetarian. That's probably offensive to a number of people. And I'm a vegetarian that was eating a bird, which is offensive to a whole other group of people. I am also someone that was talking about the idea of ethics and morality and being compassionate about animal life, which I know is offensive to certain people. So I was offending people, you know, all over the place with that one. But they're the kind of people, again, that you don't really necessarily care if I offend, because those are the kind of people that are always going to be closed-minded, that are never going to have that kind of growth mindset where, you know, they want to be challenging themselves. And again, like I said, it's an opportunity for me to think and try to reinforce those aspects of myself. You know, am I always open to different ideas? Am I always willing to question things that I think or thought were true? And the more you can do that kind of thing, I think the stronger that you would be in an emergency, in a crisis situation, where, you know, the rules may be changing by the minute, and you have to be able to adapt with those. The ability to evolve and challenge yourself, you know, well, just out in nature. Being out in nature, the animals that are the strongest are the ones that are challenged, that live in a challenging environment. You know, animals that are deep below the ocean or out in the, you know, the cold tundra or something like that. Those are really tough animals because their environment challenged them and they had to meet that challenge. Are you doing the same thing with your own brain? Are you constantly challenging your own brain so that your brain has that toughness? Your brain has that, I don't mean like tough-headed, but I mean the ability to listen to different ideas and to analyze them and to think about them in a rational and sensible way, so that you can grow when there's an opportunity to grow. You have a BS detector when there's, you know, BS in front of you, but that you don't automatically just shut things out because they're uncomfortable to you and you don't like to feel mentally challenged. I don't mean mentally challenged in that way. You know, intellectually challenged. But I think it's worth thinking about and considering the idea that, especially in crisis situations, being able to be adaptive and be open to lots of different ideas is one of the best things that you can do for yourself. It's great to have skills, great to have strength, it's great to have tools and gear and all that kind of stuff, but an open, adaptive thinking mind, again, he's having some fun over here, an open, adaptive thinking mind is really one of the greatest tool sets that you can have. That and dexterous hands. So that's it. Give us some thought. Think about it. The end of this week, we have the first alien invasion of the month coming up. It's a fun one. I actually shot some of it right in this location here. That's it. So I just thought that was a little food for thought. On Tuesday this week, tomorrow, there's another video. It's a camping video, actually. It's about cooking. Some kind of renegade cooking without enough tools, you know, kind of making stuff work. Yeah, you know, you get challenged, you come up with solutions. So I got challenged on a recent camping trip and came up with a solution for cooking stuff when I really didn't have all the tools that I thought I needed. That's it. See you on Tuesday and see you on Friday. Thanks for watching.
Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.